Thank you very much for the invitation and for the possibility to give report. I congratulate the Department of Algebra and Mathematical Logics on anniversary, and I wish members of the department and friends of the department good health, success in the work, peace, and all the best. The title of my talk is Generalized Diamonoids. Here is plan. I will start from introduction. One of the most useful concepts in algebra is the free object. Every variety contains free algebras, and free objects in any variety of algebras are important in the study of that variety. Free algebras can be characterized in terms of identities. One of the key problems that arise is the word problem for free objects in varieties. For solving this problem, it is useful to know the structure of the free object. The algebra is a vector space over a field equipped with two binary bilinear operations satisfies the following axioms d1, d2, d3, d4, d5. This notion was introduced by Lodey while studying periodicity phenomena in algebraic cassiopeia. Leibniz algebras are non-commutative variation of Lie algebras, and the algebras are variation of associative algebras. Recall that any associative algebra give rise to a Lie algebra by this formula. The algebras are related to Leibniz algebras in a way similar to the relationship between associative algebras and Lie algebras. The algebra is just a linear analog of a diamonoid. If operations of a diamonoid coincide, the diamonoid becomes a semigroup. So diamonoids are a generalization of semigroups. Pozhedayev and Kolesnikov considered the notion of a zero algebra, that is vector space of a field equipped with two binary bilinear operations satisfying the axioms D2 and D4. This notion have relationships with Rota-Baxter algebras. The notion of a zero algebra with two binary operations satisfying the axioms D1 and D5, this is associativity laws, is a linear analog of the notion of a Z diamonoid or generalized diamonoid. In order to obtain a Z diamonoid, we should omit the axiom D3 of inner associativity in the definition of a diamonoid. So we need to delete this axiom. Axioms of a diamonoid and a Z-diamonoid appear in definite identities of three algebras and of trioids introduced by Lodey and Ronco. The class of all Z-diamonoids forms a variety. Recently, free Z-diamonoids, free and nilpotent Z-diamonoids, and free commutative Z-diamonoids were constructed. The least nilpotent congruence and the least commutative congruence on the free Z-diamonoid were characterized in the paper 6 and 7 of the reference. Continuing researches from the papers 5, 6, 7. In this work, we characterize also the least diamonoid congruence on the free Z-diamonoid. Currently, there are numerous examples of diamonoids, while the number of J-diamonoids that are not diamonoids is not great. The problem is to present new examples of such algebras. In this section, we give new classes of Jedi Manoids. Recall that a Jedi Manoid or generalized demonoid is a non-empty set with two binary operations satisfying the following axioms d1, d2, d4, d5. So the demonoid is two semigroup with additional identities d2 and d4. Obviously, any dimonoid is a J-dimonoid. Next example, let X be arbitrary non-empty set, and X with star be the set of all finite non-empty words OX. Denoting the first, respectively, the last letter of a word by this way, we can define two operations on X with star by this formula. In the first formula, we use first letter of word, and in the second, we use last word of the word. It is known that this algebra is a J-dimonoid, but not a dimonoid. Next example. Let D, be a family of arbitrary J-dimonoids di, and let this set of all functions such that ef belong to di. If we have lemma p di with multiplications defined by these two formulas is a J-dimonoid. The obtained algebra is called the Cartesian product of J demonoid di. Next example. Let fx be the free semigroup of x. We denote the length of a word by lv, lw. Fix an undefined operation on direct product fx times n by these two formula. In second formula, we use length of the word w1. We note the algebra, this algebra by x and n. Lemma algebra x and n is a J-dimonoid, but not a dimonoid. Next example, let S be arbitrary semigroup by ES denote the set of all idempotent and fix two idempotent A and B from these semigroups and define operation by these formulas. Obtained algebra denote by SAB. And lemma, let S be arbitrary right cancellative semigroup and AB idempotent. If AB are non-commuting, then SAB is a J-dimonoid, but not a dimonoid. And second statement, if A and B are commuting, then SAB is a dimonoid. this is a dual case. We use left cancellative semigroup and obtain lemma. Let S be arbitrary left cancellative semigroup. If A and B non-commuting, then SAB is a J-dimonoid, but not a dimonoid. And if A and B are commuting, then this algebra is a dimonoid. Let S be arbitrary semigroup and AB arbitrary element from S. Define operations on S by these two formulas. Obtained algebra denote by SAB. We have lemma. If AB A idempotent, then SAB is a diamond. Next example will be used in the construction of free objects. Let Y be arbitrary non-empty set, S be some monoid defined on the set of finite words over Y, and theta is empty words, which is unit of S. Denote the operation on S by star and the length of word where by L. Fix elements AB, K, and define operation on S using this formula. In first formula we use A and in second B. And also we use length of words from S. The obtained algebra is denoted by S, A, B, K. And we have lemma, let T be the free monoid in the alphabet Y, then for any A, B, any K, the algebra T, A, B is a J monoid. If A is not equal to B, then it is not J monoid. The following lemma gives an answer on the question when SABK is a D monoid. Let M be the free commutative monoid in the alphabet Y. For any AB from IK, algebras MABK and TAAK are D monoid. Note that independence of axioms of a D monoid follows from the independence of axioms of a D monoid. So we have many examples of the D monoids. We know about independence of the system of axioms of a D monoid. And the problem is to construct free object in variety of generalized D monoids. Finding absolutely free structures and relatively free structures is a central problem in abstract algebra. To study J-D monoids in general, it is useful to start with relatively free J-D monoids. Even this computation are quite complicated. In this section, we construct Lodey free D monoid. With the help of properties of free D monoids and free diazebras, free diazebras were described and homology of diazebras was investigated by Lodey in the work one from reference. Consider this construction of free objects in the world of D monoids. Let X be arbitrary non-empty set, fix n, and denote the union and n different copies x degree n by yn, and assume dx is a union of such sets. Using this denotation, we can define two operations on dx by these two formulas. And we have Lodey's theorem. Dx with these multiplications is the free D monoid on the set X. The D monoid which is isomorphic to Dx was given in the paper 8 of the reference. The construction of some relatively free D monoids can be found in the same paper. Next section. Free J-D monoids. Recall that free J-D monoid was first constructed in the joint paper of Mavsisyan. The J-D monoid, which is isomorphic to the free J-D monoid, was given in paper 6. Recall this construction. let X be arbitrary non-empty set, and let W be arbitrary word in the alphabet X. The length of W will be denoted by LV. Let father T be the free monoid of Frank. Theta is empty word and star is operation on T. Define operation on T, on the free monoid, assuming. In the first formula we use A and length of the word U2, and in the second formula we use element B and length of the word U1. The obtained algebra is denoted by TAB1. Let Fx be the free semigroup of X, and XTAB1 is set of all pair from direct product with additional conditions. Difference between length of words is equal to 1. By theorem 1 from the paper 6, XTAB1 is a free J-demon. Free and nilpotent J-demonoid. Here we construct a free object in the variety of n nilpotent J-demonoid. Element 0 of a J-demonoid D is called 0 if if this element is zero for every operation of a J-demonoid. A J-demonoid D with zero is called nilpotent if for some n and any x e and star g from this set, any parenthesis of expression x1 etc. x n plus 1 gives zero. The least such n is called the nilpotent index of D. For k from n, a nilpotent J-demonoid of nilpotent index less or equal k is said to be k-nilpotent. Obviously, that operation of any one nilpotent J-demonoid coincides, and it is a zero semigroup. It is not difficult to see that the class of all n nilpotent J demonoids is subvariety of the variety of all the demonoids. J demonoid which is free in the variety of n nilpotent J demonoids will be called a free n nilpotent J demonoid. Fix n and using notation from the section 3 and 4, assume Jn is the set of pairs from free J-demonoid with such condition, length of word less or equal n. And further, we can define operation on Jn by this way. We can see that the operation depends on length of words W1, W2. The algebra Gn with this multiplication is denoted by Gnx. And we can formulate theorem. Gnx is a free and nilpotent J-demonoid. In this section, we construct free algebra in the variety of commutative J-demonoids. Recall that a J-demonoid D is called commutative if both semigroups are commutative. A J-demonoid which is free in the variety of commutative J-demonoids is called a free commutative J-demonoid. Now we give example of a J-demonoid which will be used further. Let A arbitrary non-empty set. A with line is such set, and for every X assume and introduce a map alpha by the following rule. Uh, define operation on S union S line, where S is arbitrary semigroup, by the formulas. In these formulas we use map alpha S here, alpha. Instead A we write S, semigroup S. Obtain the algebra denoted by S alpha. It is known that S alpha is a J dimonoid, but not a dimonoid. If S is commutative, then S alpha is a commutative dimonoid. And if X is a generated set for semigroup S, then S alpha minus X is line is a J subdimonoid of S alpha generated by S. We denote by FC J dx, J dimonoid S alpha minus X is line in which S is free commutative semigroup on X. So we take instead S free commutative semigroup on the alphabet X. And we have theorem. F C G D X is a free commutative sediment. The last section is devoted to studying congruences on free algebra. The least nilpotent congruence and the least commutative congruences on the free J-dimonoid were characterized in the paper 6 and 7. And this section we characterize the least dimonoid congruence on the free J-dimonoid. Let X be arbitrary monempate and W be arbitrary word of X. For every X, the number of occurrence of the element X in W is denoted by DXW. Now we give two definitions. If rho is congruence on a J dimonoid D such that factor is a dimonoid, we say that rho is a dimonoid congruence. And if rho is congruence on a J dimonoid D such that operation of factor algebra coincide, we say that rho is a semigroup. And this theorem describes the least dimonoid congruence and the least semigroup congruence. Let XTAB1 be the free J dimonoid from section 4. I recall construction of free J dimonoid. We have a free monoid T of rank 2 and define on T operation by this way using Lange, here A, here B. Then we take XTAB is a subdirect product of we have a product free semigroups and TAB1. And we use additional condition difference between Lange of vertices equal to 1. So XTAB1 is a free J dimonoid. We use this construction in the last theorem. Next, let W1 and W2 arbitrary elements from free J dimonoid and define a relation H tilde on XTAB1 by this group. So this element is in this relation if and only if first components coincide and DBU1 is equal to DBU2, where DXW is the number of occurrences of the element X in the word W. Then H tilde is the least demonoid congruent on XTAB1. And second statement, define a relation on XTAB by this rule. So element is in this relation if and only if first component coincides. Then A tilde is the least semigroup congruence on XTAB1. Note that the algebras and demonoids were studied in different papers. See, for example, references. Okay, the first paper in reference about the algebras. In this paper, Lodey introduced the notion of the algebra and the notion of demonoid. In the paper 5, Mavsisyan Davidov Safarian introduced the notion of G-demonoid. And in the paper, they construct three objects in this variety. Next, in the paper 6, the G-demonoid, which is isomorphic to the free G-demonoid, was presented. In the paper 7, free commutative G-demonoids were constructed. Paper 8, is devoted to some constructions of relatively free demonoids. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Professor Zhichok, for your talk.